long time, memorization is the key. If you sit there counting your fingers and think of your key signatures every 2 seconds, you will die. Okay? And the main reason is, if I were to write a piece of music, am I writing everything from tonic? If I write a piece of in E major, do I have to play every other note as E? No. If I did that, I would be an idiot composer, right? Or maybe a brilliant composer. I don't know. Maybe I discovered something. But if I did that, then you could measure every interval in the key of E and you'd be fine, right? But music isn't like that. Okay, you have to move from the note you're given to the next note, so you have to be flexible all the time to know what's next, right? If I write E to G sharp, I know that's a major third. Then if the next note is G sharp to B, I have to know that that's a minor third. And I have to know it immediately. I can't go, well, in the key of G, and if I add a sharp to that, this minor third. You know what I'm saying? I got to play, and I'm already like 16 measures behind the ensemble by the time I figured out my interval. You know what I mean? And so that's the kind of, if you think more instantaneously, you're better off, okay? Use it as a crutch, but understand that it's a crutch to use your key signatures for this, okay? All right, so let's talk about triads, okay? Triads are our next big mountain to climb. Now, anybody got a quick definition of a triad for me?
It's the first, third, and fifth of a scale.
Okay. Yeah, that's a good one. I'm going to go even broader than that. I'm going to say a triad is a three-note chord. A triad is a three-note chord. Tri, three, right? So I get three notes. Now, this is where what you said comes relevant. It has to be spelled in this order. I have to have a root note, I have to have a third, and I have to have a fifth. If I can't make that happen, I don't have a triad. Okay? And visually what that looks like, hang on just 1 second and I'll get that question.
Sorry.
No, it's okay. It looks like this. Now, what's your question?
I was asking what the R was for, but he
root.
Told me it was
yeah. Triad. Now, this is a triad in root position. Okay, we'll get into more of inversions and stuff like that with chords. Most of you may already know kind of what an inversion is if you don't know exactly what it is. But right now we're only interested in chords in root position. Okay? And when I know it's in root position is when it can be space, 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 or line, 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 because that gives me root, third, fifth. You see that every time I've got that organization? When I see it like this, I know that the bottom note is the root. And that means that I'm going to name the chord that letter in some kind of quality. So it's going to be D, major, minor, augmented, diminished. This one, again, I got to play it from the top, I guess, but this would be E, major, minor, augmented, diminished, depending on what quality we figure out that it is, right? But if it's in root position, I know that that is the root. Okay? So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to figure out what are my, essentially there's like formulas for these, right? Like we have these certain intervals and we get these certain triads, right? So the first thing we want to talk about is I want to know what a major triad is. Okay? So if I write a major triad, I'm going to say, okay, root to third, what is that relationship? Okay, if it's a major triad, what do you think that might be? Major, right? That would make sense, okay? So I'm going to say that a root to, well, I'm not going to say, music is going to say, that a root to a third for a major triad has to be a major third, okay? And then I said root, third, fifth. So the other interval I'm interested in is this root to fifth relationship. What is this guy? It's got to be a perfect fifth, right? So I've got two things here, okay? I've got the outer shell, and then I've got the gooey center. Okay? If this outer shell is perfect, then I know that I'm going to get some kind of major or minor triad, and I look to the third to tell me what I'm going to get. make sense?
Yes.
Okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to go in and we're going to write out some triads, but we're going to start by writing out perfect fits. Because all I want to do is look at major triads, right? Okay? All I want to see is major triads. So I know that I have to have perfect fits. So I'm going to start here. I'm going to say, okay, C to G is a perfect fit, so that's a good shell. D to A is a perfect fit, so there's another good shell. D to B, F to C, G to D. Remember, all of these are natural to natural except this one. What do I need up here?
F-sharp.
F-sharp for the perfect fit, right? So now what I know is, whatever happens now, I know that the outside is correct. Now I just need to go, I want major everything, okay? So what's a major third above C?
E.
Very good. So now I've made a major triad. So this would be, I would just label it C with a capital C. Okay? And that, the fact that it's capital and it's by itself means that this is a major triad. Does that make sense? I'm no longer using this as a letter reference, I'm using it as a chord reference. Okay? Now, I'm coming over here and I want D major. That's what I'm looking for, right? So what I'm going to say is, okay, what's a major third above D?
F-sharp.
F-sharp. So now I have major third, I knew I had a perfect fit, I've met my criteria for a major triad, okay? Coming over here, I'm looking for E major. Major third above E?
G-sharp.
G-sharp, very good. And then I come over here, major third above F, major third above G. All right, now I get over here, A, what's in the key of A, guys? F sharp, C sharp, G sharp, right? So this for a major third is gonna be C sharp. And then here for B, I've gotta have a D sharp for that major third, right? So this is what major triads look like, okay? And these are all labeled according to their letter because that's what I call them. If you notice, the bottom note, C, D, E, F, G, these are all root position triads, okay? Now, what an inversion does, an inversion takes the chord and says, I want those notes but not in that order. So have I changed any of the components? The components are all the same, right? I still have C, E, G. But now I have to go looking to see what would make this a root position. Like, if I showed you that and you're like, I'm like, what triad? And you're like, well, I don't know, right? Well, what you would do is say, okay, if I put C down here, do I get a root position chord now? So C is the name of this chord, regardless of where C is. Does this make sense? That's what inversions do. Okay? If I were to change it up even more, let's put that there. Have I changed any of the components? No. The components are all there, right? So, again, if you looked at this and you're like, I don't know what chord I'm looking at. You go through and you say, okay, what if G were up here? Do I get a root position triad now? I do, right? So then I would analyze, okay, C to G is a perfect fit, C to E is a major third, that's a major triad, C is the root. So it's still a C chord. So I mean, that's what inversions are. They're just scrambling the ingredients, okay? Now, let's take a slightly different tactic for a second. Let's take this. If I see something like this, I have to look at it and say, can I get it in thirds? That's my criteria for figuring out if something's a triad, okay? So I would say, that's obviously not in thirds. Okay, so now I'm gonna look at it again. I'm gonna say, okay, C to F to G. Well, again, that's not in thirds, right? Like that didn't work. So let's try it one more time. F to G to C. Well, you can see it's still not in thirds. So this is not a triad at all. Does that make sense? So if you see a three-note grouping, but you can't make it into this kind of shape, then you're not dealing with a triad. that make sense? It has to be able to come into this shape for it to qualify. Okay? It doesn't mean that this isn't a chord, it's just not a triad. Okay? Chord is like the overarching umbrella of all the crazy that can happen, right? Triad is a really specific definition within that. Yeah?
Can you just think about the space, line, line, line?
Sure, yeah. Well, and this is where you, if you can reorganize it and make it into space, 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 line, 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 then you have it. So for instance, if you look at this, this is out of order, right? But if I unscramble it, essentially, I get the triad shape coming back. I have to be able to find that for it to work. If none of it will work, then I know I'm out. Now, how many possible positions are there going to be for a three-note chord? There's going to be three. Okay, because I can only put it in three before it starts to repeat itself. Okay, so if I take a triad and I say, okay, here's a C major triad. This is in bass clef. Okay, so I've got C, E, G, and then I take the bottom note and I just throw it up here in the top. There's E, G, C, and then I take the bottom note and I throw it in the top. And then if I do it again, what I end up with is another root position. Now, this isn't in the same octave anymore, but it's the same order again. You see that? I've gone back to root, third, fifth. So there's only ever three positions in a three-note chord. So if you're hunting in your music and you see this and you're like, Jesus, is it a triad or not? You get three tries before you figure out that it wasn't. Does that make sense? So you don't have to keep repeating it and repeating it and repeating it until you're like driving yourself crazy. Three tries will tell you. Okay? So let's take this for instance. If I were to go, let's say bass clef, okay? Let's play our new game show. Is it a triad, you know? Okay, so what I would do is I would try to figure out, does it fit in this line, 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 space, space, space format? Can I make it do that? I can, okay? What I would do here, the faster way to do it is to take this guy and put it below. And then you see it, okay? But even if you just only ever want to do things in an upward direction, okay, well then, well that wasn't quite it. Oh, there it is. Now, if I wanted to analyze this, F to C, is it a perfect fifth? F to A, is it a major third? So this is an F major chord, it just isn't in root position. Okay, and here's the thing that'll until you get these triads memorized, going through and saying, okay, I've got to find that root position to know what it is fine. I used to do this all the time. I'd go, okay, well, if that's the root, then I measure the intervals, okay? So I say major third, perfect fifth, and good. Now, what do you think if I were to go through and make all the thirds minor? What do you think happens then? Becomes a minor triad, okay? So if I'm looking for minor triads, and here's kind of an important part of that, the shell stays the same for major and minor. I still have a perfect fifth shell for minor triads, but the center changes to a minor third. Okay, so this outer thing is not, you're still looking at the perfect fifth shell, but now I'm gonna go through and I'm gonna make all these minors. So I know this is a major triad, right? C to E is major, C to what is minor? E flat. So now if I'm gonna label this, I would say C minor. And the fact that I wrote this with the M tells you that it's minor. Okay, if it were major, I wouldn't bother with an M at all. Does this make sense? All right. Then I come over here, this is D major. D to F sharp is major, so D to what is minor? What? F. So I just get rid of the sharp, because that's a half step smaller. Now I've got a D minor triad. Okay? Again, same process. If I get rid of this sharp, I've made it a half step smaller for the third, so there's D minor.
play at a flat, at a take away the sharp, but you have to keep the F sharp for the perfect fifth, right? I can't take both of these away or I get something different. Now, this is exactly like intervals, but it's a bigger bus, okay? So if I move one of these, like let's say that I do that, right? If I need to preserve this chord, all of these have to go up a half step. Just like with the intervals, right? If I moved one, I had to move the others to preserve the quality, right? So if I move all of these up, now this is D sharp minor. Right? And I get that name because that root is D sharp. Right? So I just call it whatever the bottom note is, as long as I'm spelling it in thirds. If I were to do the other side of this, let's say that I took these down like that. Everything moved an equivalent amount, right? So I didn't actually change the quality, but I did change the root. Right, and I have to tell you that. Okay. Now, this is a rare chord. It's not something you're gonna see a lot, but let's say I want an F flat minor. Okay? This goes down a half step, then so does this, which means I'm gonna have an A double flat there. And then I would have a C flat on top. Okay, it's not something you're gonna see a lot of, by the way. But that would be the literal answer to that question if I were to ask it. Right? And it's possible to see stuff like this, it's just not always common. What will happen a lot though, let's take a look at the majors one more time. Let's say I have D, F sharp, A, that's a D major chord, right? What if I make it D sharp? And I need D sharp major. Well, what happens to F?
Double sharp.
F double sharp. And this is actually a pretty common chord. That's not a super rare thing to see. Okay? So again, just because it looks kind of funny doesn't mean that it's like ultra rare or even all that complicated. It just is what it is. Right? Now, I wouldn't start by trying to memorize the weirdest thing on the planet. I'd start by trying to memorize D major, right? Because that actually makes sense. Okay? And then you just apply the rest to it. Okay. So what I'm going to do, guys, is I'm going to give you a series of triads. Some are going to be in root position, some are going to be in inversion, okay? And I want you to take the ones that are in inversion and make them in root so you can figure out what the root is, and then tell me if it's major or minor, okay? If it's already in root position, then just tell me if it's major or minor. Okay, so my process right now would be, if I were to take it like that, now it is. So now I can proceed with how I know to analyze, right? So fifth is perfect. Third is major. What's the root? So it's a G major triad. Okay. Again, not in root. If I move this up, now it is. Okay. What's my root?
C.
Okay. Fifth is perfect. Third is
minor.
So it's a C minor triad. And then if I come over here, I need to move this up. Well, that's still not in root position, right? Like I'm still, now, one thing that I would do, guys, the more you get off the staff, the harder this gets to do, especially if you're kind of new to it. So I would take these and move them down, okay? The next move would be to take this one and put it up, but instead of just moving the other two down. Now am I in root position?
Yes,
okay. What's my bottom note?
G.
What's my third?
B.
So is that major or minor?
Major.
Okay, so it's a G major triad. And then the same thing's gonna happen here. I could go up twice or I could just bring this down once. I'm just gonna bring this down once, okay? Does that make sense? So I'm gonna say, okay, A is my root. A to C is major or minor?
Minor,
so this is an A minor triad. All right, now this is already in root position. Do I know everything off of F flat? Maybe I do, maybe I don't, right? One way you could, one way you can approach this is if they're all flat, just cover it up with your hand and say, okay, what if these were all natural? Would I know the answer, right? So if F to A is major, F flat to A flat is major. If F to C is perfect, F flat to C flat is perfect, right? So this is an F flat major chord, okay? And then again, not in root position, so I'm gonna take this one, move it up. Remember if you do this, to take the flat or sharp with you if it's there, right? Because if you get rid of it, it changes everything, okay? So you've gotta preserve everything as you found it. Same thing here. I could think in G flat. It's fine if I know that. That's actually great if I know that. If you're confused, I would just do this. Is G to B major? Yes. G flat to B flat is major. Is G to D perfect? Yes. G flat to D flat is perfect. So this is a G flat major triad. One thing, guys, is just kind of a shortcut. If you're dealing with these two shapes, okay, these are the inverted shapes, right? The gap, if the gap's on top, bring the note down, and that'll give you an immediate root position. So if I take the big gap, and I put it below because it was on top, now I'm in root position, okay? If the gap is below, put it on top, and you go straight to root position. Instead of having to do one twice, right? That's one thing I would recommend. So I can just take any shape and immediately unscramble it by knowing, okay, then I just need to move that one up, and I get the shape that I need.
So that's, is that true always, regardless of?
Obviously take the sharp flat with you, but yeah. Now, again, slower processes will work if you really are afraid of jumping a step and making a mistake, don't, right? But a lot of these principles are similar enough that we can limit it, right, and hopefully speed up our response. things I want you to study right now, okay? I want you to really study your thirds and your fifths, okay? Because those are the building blocks of triads, if you've noticed, right? Like, that's what we do most of our stuff with right now, okay? So study your majors, study your minors, and then study your perfects, okay? Make sure you really know those really solid, because that's what's building these major-minor triads, okay? And then once you do it, what I would say is go use a piano whenever you do any of this stuff, right? Because then you can look at it as well, as, you know, play it, you can hear it, hit a bunch of different connections in your brain, okay? And then when you play it, I would say, you know, say it to yourself. So you look at it on the paper, I wrote a C major triad. I played a C major triad, and I told myself, it's a C major triad, out loud. Like, I know that seems weird, like, but talk to yourself, it's fine, okay? This is C major, boom, right, and you play it. This is D minor, boom, and you play it. And that's going to create more connections in your brain, right? The more associations you can build, the better your memory becomes, and the more things you have to grab onto to remember something. If the only practice you ever get is writing these down on paper silently in your head, that's not going to get it done, ultimately, right? That's not the way music works. It's just how we do it in this class, okay? So outside in your lab hour, get a keyboard, play these, say them, practice them, okay? And then practice rearranging them. Say, if I give you all root position, or if you write down all root position, then try changing it. Say, what would happen if I were to play it like that? What does that look like? What does that feel like, right? So you're starting to build more connections to these chords, and it's not just some abstract exercise on paper. Does that make sense? Okay. So, what I'm going to do, Monday I'm going to have a quiz for you guys, okay? And I'm just going to have it, it's going to be like, kind of like what we did on the interval stuff, where it's literally just write them in, and then we'll go over it together on Monday. Okay, so you'll take it, I'll give you maybe however long I think you need for it, and then we'll go over it together. So we